Welcome all, it's Russ, and in this video, we're gonna be talking about two of the most common string processing functions that we have. They're known as strip and split. And it's gonna be easiest to see this if I can type some values here. So let's have x equals input, and then we'll print out a couple of things. We'll print out the length of x. But then let's also, well, let's just start with that. Let's imagine that I just put in a whole bunch of white space here. And then I hit enter. So the length of what input gave me was 45. So it read 45 characters from the keyboard. What if I do some spaces and then ASDF and then some lots more spaces? I get 130 characters here. All right, well, sometimes spaces are really important. That's the reason input gives them to you. Python doesn't know whether you're gonna care about all those white spaces or not. And so input will give you them, but now you have to decide whether they're useful information. In a lot of programs, you're gonna find out that they're not really. And so the first thing that you can do is that you can do something called strip. Now what strip is gonna do is it's going to take your existing string and it's gonna look for all of the white space. White space is spaces and tabs and new line characters. It's gonna take all the white space at the beginning of your string and all the white space at the end of your string and remove it. It's not going to remove anything in the middle. All right, so let's go here and let's change it. Y equals x dot strip. Now you'll notice here that we don't call it strip of x because strip is not actually a global function defined by Python. Instead, it's a method of the string class. We'll talk more about methods when we go to string to class definitions, but right now what you can say is strip is something that you do on strings, just like append was something that you do on arrays. All right, so you can say, what is the length of y? So let's print this out. And we'll do big long text, ASDF, big long text. Hit enter. The length of x was 55, but then we said y equals x dot strip. The length of y is 4. And we can actually print these out with a little bit more so it's a little bit more visible. Let's put in, all right, that's a weird thing I typed. What did I just type? Double quote, single quote, double quote. Well, it's, when we see double quote, what we know is beginning of a string. The string's gonna continue until we get to the double quote at the end. So double quote, single quote, double quote means a string with exactly one character in it, and that character is a single quote. All right, so let's print out x plus, and these bounds here, now when we print it out, what we'll find is that we'll be able to use the single quotes to figure out how much white space there is in x. And let's print out y the same way, but just for fun, let's do it the other way around. Remember that Python doesn't really tell a difference in its string constants between single and double quotes. So if you wanted to have a string that was just a single quote, you can use double, single, double. Well, if you want to create a string in Python that's just a double quote, what could you do? Single, double, single. That's kind of fun. All right, so now when we run it, I've got a syntax, oh, I didn't put a plus here. All right, whole bunch of spaces, whole bunch more spaces. All right, so it prints things out. And what are you gonna see? All right, so this first line is where I was actually doing my typing. This is our first line of printout. The length of x was 46. It then printed x surrounded by single quotes. So you see that. Then it stripped x. and it said, here's the length of y, and then it printed y surrounded by double quotes. So that's what strip is doing. It's removing front and back spaces. What if you've got spaces in the middle? It will not do anything. Big wide space, some spaces at the end. It printed out ASDF JKL. When it strips it down, it gets rid of the leading space, the trailing space, but not all the spaces in the middle. What happens if there's not any white space? It's happy. Strip is happy to say, well, there wasn't anything to do. I didn't make any changes. All right, so what about split? Split is a very useful one for breaking things up into columns. All right, so let's change this now to split. And then we'll gonna remove these. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna type ASDF JKL QWERTY. And what did it print? All right, so this first line is where I typed, then said there were 15 characters in the string. Here's the string that I typed. And then, that's weird. I went ahead and I printed the length of y. Why does it say that the length of y is 3? It's because the split function returns a list, an array. Returns a Python list. And what's inside that array? A set of strings, which are the words from that string broken up by white space. So we had ASDF space JKL space QWERTY. So when we call split, what do we get? We get something of length 3. It's an array of length 3. It has 3 strings inside of it. ASDF, JKL, and QWERTY. What happens if there's a whole bunch of white space? Let's put some leading white space in. ASDF, some big white space. JKL, one space. QWERTY, trailing space. Let's see what happens. All right, big long string originally, 66 characters in it. It broke it down, it was still 3. The way split works here is that it removes leading space, just like strip does, removes trailing space, and if you got lots of white space in the middle, it just collapses all that down. It looks at this string, and it says that string has exactly 3 words of interest in it, ASDF, JKL, and QWERTY. So this is going to be fundamental to a lot of the input processing you're gonna do in this class. We're gonna read something from the keyboard or read something from a file. You're gonna need to break it up into simple little words so you can run an algorithm. And you're gonna find yourself using strip and split quite a bit. Hope this was useful. Hope it was informative. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.